You wanted me to ask this, and I thought this was a good question. Why not use systemic therapy in combination with treatment of solitary metastatic sites? So, I mean, you're making it sound like, okay, we hit these sites that are by themselves, but on one hand, you're saying, let's throw the kitchen sink at it. But when it comes to oligometastatic, you're saying with these isolated sites, no, don't do that. So is that counterintuitive, or I mean,
It is, and I'm really conflicted, because it's exactly, you saw that last case where the guy had two spots. We hit the two spots, but we also give taxotere and hormone therapy, and that guy is free of disease. So, I've been trying to develop estimators of hitting one spot. You're going to knock out the disease. And we've been looking through all our data. Is it the brightness? Is it the location? Is it this or is it that? It's totally stochastic. We cannot find something that says if you hit that one spot, you're going to win. So I am conflicted by it because hitting it and winning is a minor subset of the outcomes. But at the same time, it's a big ask to tell a patient, well, you got this one little spot. You should do chemotherapy, hormone therapy, and everything else because obviously systemic therapy has side effects. Some of the side effects are a little bit unpleasant. You just don't know. So the way we do it typically is we go ahead and shoot the one spot. We hope we get lucky. We hope it's an excellent outcome. And if it ain't, then we immediately start scrambling towards maybe we should get the deluxe package. That's the way we're handling it right now. But it's not that way for everyone. We lay it out for the patient. We tell them, what do you want to do? Do you want to try it or do you want to just, go with a big package? Some of the patients don't want to do any of the things we recommend, and we respect that also,
I think what you're, but I think what you're saying, which is not wrong, you're saying when it comes to oligometastatic disease, less may be more, but there are clearly other situations in prostate cancer because it's a heterogeneous and it's an ugly disease for many, that sometimes more is more. And you got, and the art is deciding when less is more and when more is more. Is that helpful?
Absolutely. No, that's exactly right. And one of the reasons I wanted to include this in the talk is because, it's so classic. In the beginning, when I first started talking about targeting oligometastatic disease, people, call you up and say, you're all wet. It's not going to work. That's a dumb idea, blah, blah, blah. And then all of a sudden it got hot. Everyone's doing oligometastatic disease now, and they're claiming they invented it. But now we're seeing a flood of patients where, a guy comes in and he's got five spots and they've shot radiation at everything. And I'm sitting there thinking, whoa, whoa, Nelly, I think you're asking too much of that approach. I think you have to be judicious. So I kind of want to lay it out as, we don't know all the answers. These are the approaches, but these are also things that you should think about,